Since Scrum Master's movement and Edge Cancel are just so crisp. What?
Falco's just really good at locking down.
Yeah, that's it.
Like, you shoot lasers and he doesn't have any platforms to, like, get away
from. Ooh, I love that.
To deal with them. But Ammon is, you know, low-key god of power shielding. He's amazing at it. I don't know how he does it.
He's amazing at so many things. The stuff that he's amazing at in his like bodies just like scrubs. When he gets on the national level, like he still does really good, but like, I feel like he doesn't try to get splashy. He's still alive.
Yeah. Up air knee.
See, I'm trying to get better at that. Captain Falcon loves to do aerials from the edge.
Nice.
Oh, that's a good call out. Good space in there. Yeah, Captain Falcon loves doing aerials. Usually up air, sometimes knee.
Yeah.
Ooh, really big impact.
Falcon's ledge game is something you have to respect.
Yeah.
You can't.
At lower percent, I think you can just, a lot of them like to go for up air. At a lower percent, you can just crouch cancel and just kind of attack. But a higher percentage, you definitely have to respect a lot.
I just give him the space, honestly. Yeah. Or I try to. I'm impatient. I want to go out there and hit him. I should just give him the space.
I see Clawmaster doing this a lot. I'm trying to do it more. It's just kind of makes a habit. When he's like edge guarding, he'll usually just hop onto the platform, like on stages like this, and just kind of drop down, jump back up, and just wait for him to get up to punish. It's hard to hit someone on their own.
Oh, God.
He up smashes. Okay, he makes it back. I mean, the down smash. Yeah, what about Rita Fox in the top one that just
disappeared? Oh, I don't remember. Yeah. There's stuff going on with these things tonight.
Oh, okay, Thomas just needs like one good tech chance, but it's going to come down like who can get like a... It's okay, yeah, that's it. Yeah, set him up for the I'm going to say like one good like neutral version to a Thomas to get him off stage. Alright, well, let's... I mean, he seemed really upset after that.
He's on the board.
I mean, after game two, but he's kept his composure. He got that right. Honestly, he's turning in with the nair. Logos not falling for it. I just expect Clawmaster to get every single tech chase, and every time he misses one, it's like a breath of relief. I feel like.
Definitely really good at getting his tech.
I guess, you know, tech, or, you know, like, seeing people's tech for, like, over 10 years, over and over and over again, kind of developed dream for a lot of people's, like, what they want to get out to.
I also think he just does it mostly on reaction.
Like, gosh. I feel like, oh, gosh, he covers tech in so much. Maybe that's because people tech in so much.
Well, yeah. You have to, like, it's really hard not to, because you're getting VI in sometimes, but you have to tech, and it's really hard to, like, tech and DI in different directions.
Logo's holding his hands up. He is confused, or maybe, yeah, I'm guessing from just previous talking to him. Oh my gosh, he's still like, but just from talking to, are you serious that high up? I was gonna say, from just talking to Logo in the past, he's probably thinking, like, I can't do anything. He's still alive. He's gonna get another kill.
This is the frustration. I was playing Steam Pride, and
oh my gosh, 206?
Yeah.
237, oh my god.
Yeah, I played Steam Fright, and I wobbled him on that stage for like 160, and then forward smashed him, and he lived.
Oh,
I hit him with the double up air, he still lives. He was living past 200 on that stock.
He was in heaven, yeah. Dude, 230%. Yeah. After that second stock, it looked like Logos was just like, I don't know what to do. I'm just getting drunk right now.
Knees.
Nice refreshing taste.
Yeah.
Weak knee into it. Up there. Spool.
Spool.
Oh, yeah, right.